Hey, good morning. As you all well know, today's what? Today, 0900 prayer request. Hey, hi there. Welcome back again. You can't get enough of it, can you? All right, well, here we go again. You can just about imagine everything I'm going to say this Saturday morning. Hi. Nothing is going to change right here. Again, it is going to be, who am I going to ask? It's going to be you I'm going to be asking. Are you the prayer request? Since you guys are the first ones here this morning, I have a question for you. You ready for a question this morning? That'd be a yes or no there on your little chat screens there, my friends. All right? Hi, are you ready for a question this morning? Hi, welcome. Same thing again, but are you ready? You're the first ones on this morning. This Saturday morning, what is it? Today is the 26th of March, Saturday morning here in the United States, right here in Missouri. All right, right there. I'm Protestant Christian Missionary Norman Edgar. Are you guys ready for a question this morning? Hi, welcome. Are you ready for a question this morning? Come on, that'd be a yes or no there. Come on, guys. Hey, hi, welcome. Are you ready for a question this morning? That's all of you that's looking right now. Yeah, that's you. Yeah, that's a yes or no. Are you ready for a question this morning? Hey, hi there, welcome. Welcome, are you ready for a question this morning? I don't see any responses down there yet. Come on, are you ready for a question? I have a question for you guys. What's up? Hey, I have a question for you guys. Okay, we got one that says okay. Anybody else? I have a question for the entire group. Everybody. God is real. Yes, he's real. All right, I have a question. I think, yeah. Okay, I have a question for you. Guys, look, are you ready for a question this morning? You're the first ones to come on Periscope here. I have a question for you. All right, got another yes, got a yes, I got an okay. How about anybody else? Are you ready for a question? I have a question for all of you out there this morning. Are you ready for the question? Let me see some more responses, okay? Come on, guys. Come on, you little finger. Dot, dot. That'd be a Y-E-S or N-O, okay? Are you ready for a question? I have a question to ask. All right, let's go. All right? The question is, are you ready? The question is, do you think, now, I'm going to make the presumption that you believe in a God. God's substance called God. I think that most of you out there believe in a spiritual substance called God. Okay? Do you think, this is a question, do you think that God trusts you? Think about it. Do you think God trust you? You know, just like your parents or your friends or co-workers, do they trust you? Your good friend, do they trust you? Your siblings, your mom, dad, do they trust you? Yes. Okay, there's one yes. All right, come on, guys. Some more answers. Do you think God trust this God, this spiritual substance called God, whatever, you know, do you think this spiritual substance trust you individually, not the world, but do you think God can trust you? You might be asking, well, why would God trust me? Why wouldn't he trust you? Do you think you're an honest, sincere person? Are you a two-timer? Why wouldn't God trust you? Or why would he trust you? All right, that's the question. We got one answer, yes. So the question to you, Periscope Land, before we start today for this, because you know what I'm going to say every day, all day, it's going to be the same thing, prayer request, you talking to God. But the question this morning is, do you think God trusts you? That's the question. Hey, hi there, welcome guys, welcome. I asked a question before we start the prayer request. The question is, do you think God trusts you? You, not the world, not some other group, but you. Do you think God trusts you as an individual? Got you stumped this morning, huh? Nobody's saying nothing except I got one yes. Saturday morning, again, 26th of March. Hey, hi there. Saturday morning, 26th of March, about 40 degrees Fahrenheit here in Missouri, right here. He trusts me, okay. That's two. The question is, do you think this spiritual substance called God trusts you? Hey, hi there. Hi, welcome. I have a question this morning. Do you think God trusts you? That's for everybody that's plugged on here to the Periscope right now. Before we begin the 0900 prayer request time, a question. Do you think God, the spiritual substance called God, trusts you? People think this is a trick question. Well, that's okay. Do you think God trusts you? There's no trick question, it's a simple question. Yes. There we got another yes. So we got three yeses. Okay, how many people I got on Periscope right now? Look, you guys look on your smartphones. How many people are looking right now at us? Can somebody tell me? How many people you see on your smartphone in this conversation? Six. So I got 50% of you guys saying something. Okay, what about the other three? Do you, or other five, do you think, and you other five out there, you're looking at me, question, do you think God trusts you? It's a thought-provoking question, right? But, you know, do you think God trusts you? You know, you'd say, well, let's say you're working a job somewhere, do you think your boss trusts you? Okay, if you're a foreman, manager, do you think the people trust you? Say a story from your life, it would be more interesting. Well, I have a lot of stories to tell, but that's not what it's about. It's about this, prayer request. So again, hey, hi there everybody, thank you for coming in, but look, before we start the 0900 prayer request, I'm still wanting to know, do you know Father Dixie Normus? No, don't know Father Dixie. My question to everyone out here is, before we start, and I'll probably tell you a story about me somewhere along the line, but do you think God trusts you? This spiritual substance. Hey, hi. Hi there, Russia. Hi, everybody. The question before we start, I do, Father. No, I'm too much of a savage, right? Okay, so we got one negative. Question, do you think this spiritual substance called God trusts you? Okay. All right. No. Nope. No? Okay. All right. Oh, 900 prayer requests. It's not a trick question. Okay, yes. How many of you people, I got a lot of answers. I don't give them a reason to. Maybe. Okay. All right. All right. Well, okay, let me ask you a question. Not about God. Okay, not about God. Ready? Okay, hold on, guys. Take a break. Take a sip of coffee like me. Hey, good, huh? Oh, by the way, it's evening time there in Russia and on the other side of the planet. Hey, but before I ask, say something, look at this. This is our Periscope map, right? You guys want to see this? Look here, my friends. Look here, I'm going to show you. Right here, this is St. Charles, Missouri, right here. Right? And this is all of Asia here. This is India, right? Up in through here. Look, Indonesia, Australia, New Zealand, right? And then look at all this. These are all the people that's contacted me. And I mean really contacted me that I've chatted with. Look at all this. Norway, Sweden, all in England, UK, into Europe, and down through all the different countries of Europe, all right? Saudi Arabia, Dubai, all of Northern Africa, down into South America, Ethiopia, all the way down the south, all right? Then we go into Brazil, all right? All the islands right here in Puerto Rico, Florida, Mexico, and all over within the United States, including the Poconos Mountains in Pennsylvania. And up here, as of yesterday, we had 52,307 hearts. And views to date is 4,000 views, 4,094. But do you realize that is only from the last month? Month and 2 weeks, maybe. All right. And if you listen to me, you know I'm just talking the same old talk every day. I'm like a broken record. I'm just saying the same thing, flipping the signs to you. I mean, you know, flipping the sign. I mean, a good sign here. Hello. All right. Let's stay above board here. All right. So, you guys, a lot of you guys will remember, here's the original paper. I'm keeping it. See that? Man, isn't that in good shape? My wife, Selma, said, throw that away. I said, no, we got to keep that. And here's a new sign she made for me. We splurged and went to Walmart and bought a poster board. Cut that out in that nice cut. Look at that. Perfect handwriting. Do you know, Father? From long ago. All right. Well, you might. All right. So, I appreciate everybody coming on here, really. I appreciate you coming because, you know, it's always the same old story with me. I don't care about nothing else. All I care about you. What? You got to talk to the Lord. Amen. This whole thing about being a Christian, right? I told you guys before. Okay. I don't know what that all means by that comment, okay, but the only thing I want for you guys is for you to talk to the Lord. That's all. Stay away from all these religious faiths, all of them. Protestant religion, the Roman Catholic, Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, all of them. Seventh-day Adventist, Mormon, Jehovah, Witness, Baptist, Methodist, you name it, Pentecost. Stay away from them. All right, just stay away. You'll get more confused and you'll become a bigot. You know what a bigot, you know what that word means? Bigotry. Bigotry means that you are against someone because of what they represent. And not only are you against what they represent, but you as a bigot person, want great bodily harm to come to that other person. That's a bigot. It's not the same as a racist. A bigot and a racist are not the same. A racist is somebody just don't like you because of the color of your skin, but he doesn't want great bodily harm to come to you. A bigot does. You walk into them church houses and they'll divide you right down the line. And if you're not careful, you'll become a racist like American blacks are now. The American blacks are overwhelmed with racism and they don't even know it. It's the very thing that they fought against, right? And now it consumes them. But they don't see it. That's the way sin, that's sin, by the way. Just like the white people were in the southern states of the United States said, oh yeah, we're Christian, and then they slip on the white robes. Hello. Racism is there, okay? It's sin, it's evil. It's going to be with us until Jesus comes back. Okay, that's the honest truth, all right? That doesn't mean I condone it or encourage it. It's just there, all right? Because sin is evil. And there's only one way you're going to get rid of it, and that's by being converted, all right? And the only way you get converted is when you as individuals, you right there, you, the individual, you're going to have to get real with God in your life. You're going to read the Protestant, Christian, Bible, New Testament truths of Jesus. You alone. And I guarantee you, you don't need anybody. Hey, hi, you don't need anybody to explain to you the truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. You don't need to go to that church house and sit there and let somebody explain to you. You can read that Protestant, Christian, Bible, New Testament words of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. It was written for the illiterate, uneducated person. You can get it. As a missionary, I've been one for 40 years. Something I've learned. You know, we all kind of go through different stages about stuff. But something I've learned, you got to have faith in the people that you want to believe in Christ. I have to have the faith that I have to trust you, that you will indeed read the Protestant, Christian, Bible, New Testament truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. I have to trust that you will. I have to trust that you'll decide. I'll have to trust that you'll make the right decision. I have to trust that as I go to the next groups of people and tell them the very same thing that I'm saying to you. You understand, the trust factor is that I have to trust, in other words, I have to have faith that what God starts in your life, God's able to finish. I don't have to come by and wet nurse you and spoon feed you every little thing because you're a new Christian, you're a baby Christian, you're on the milk of the word, all this kind of stuff that people like to say. You understand, people that become Christian, they got this idea that they got to run to a church house and somebody's got to explain to them how to love somebody. Hello? It's a natural thing when you're spiritually born again, but if you're not spiritually born again, you'll struggle left and right, and that's the Christianity today. One big hypocritical mess, all right? Well, that's an interesting question. I think that question wouldn't be correct because if I created somebody myself, I would take great pleasure that was created. And if I create a free will thinking human, what kind of God person would I be if I only wanted that person to praise me? And, you know, in other words, am I making little robots to fulfill my narcissistic needs? No. And that's a unique thing about a human. He's got this free will, all right? But the free will is in sin, in darkness. And that's a part that people just don't understand. This is a real tough thing for people to understand. And that's a part of the gospel message. Jesus said to go teach and make disciples. So you have to understand grace, justification, and repentance. When you understand, when you have the head knowledge, hey, hi there, welcome. When you have the head knowledge about that, then you're going to decide about this part. Repent means to turn your life to the teachings of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist, in the Protestant Christian Bible only, not to some church, not to some denominational doctrine. No, absolutely not. It's going to be between you and the Lord. That's it. There's nobody else involved. You're going to either surrender the right to yourself to the truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. You're going to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. You'll become a servant to Jesus. That's repentance, and you alone have to make that decision. It's not a learn-as-you-go thing. That's a part of the gospel message. There's millions of people like my wife and Selma, my wife and I, and that is to go forth, teach, and make disciples. Right? It's not a hit and miss thing. I know that some of you out there are going to become disciples of the Lord. I know that some of you out there are in the process of submitting and giving up the right to yourself to the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. I trust God. God says His words don't go out in vain. They don't come back void. In other words, what is spoken in the name of the Lord comes back. Maybe I won't see it, but it's coming to you and it's going to help change your life for you to be a spiritually born-again Christian and following only Jesus' truth found only in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. Okay? Hey, hi there, Russia. Welcome to what? Welcome to the 0900 prayer request. Prayer request. Amen? Look at this, isn't this a flip chart? Hey, pretty good, huh? Are we good here? And this is Missouri, this is where I'm at. And here, let me get this up here. I'm Norman, I'm 70. Selma, my wife, 68. All right, 40 years as Protestant Christian missionary. Talking to you about Jesus. Today, we're talking about this. Prayer requests. You talking to God. You know, Selma and I were talking the other day. And I've had lesson plans and everything that I help people with. But you know something, we enter into a place now that we have to believe that you trust God. Right? I believe that you guys are trusting God. Maybe you won't admit it so much right now, but you will. You know why? Because he loves you. You're not going to find a fault with him. You might not understand all the reasons why things are going on in your private life. But one thing about it, you'll keep searching around and you realize that he loves you and he's got good involved for you. Amen. He loves you, sent Jesus for you, set you free. Amen. And when he sets you're free indeed. You end up being old fanatical like us for Jesus. Amen. 0900 prayer request time. Amen. Talking. That's what praying is. Talking to who? Talking to God. Hey, Lord. Do you want him to walk? Do you want to walk with the Lord in the cool of the night as Adam did, recorded in Genesis, the first book of the Protestant Christian Bible, Old Testament? Do you want to walk with the Lord? Huh? You want that peace and joy in your life? The New Testament says that the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. And one of the things I found out is that you and me, we don't know what the actual desire of our hearts are until God reveals them to us. All right? God brings this joy and happiness, this freedom from sin and guilt, this overwhelming sense of being loved by God is overwhelming. And it's that love from God that motivates you and me to go and minister to other people that were like us before we got saved, like you before you got saved, walking in darkness, unaware of the spiritual truths that are all around them, thinking that today's religion is the right path. But today's religions are demonic in origin. The Roman Catholic, Islam, Hindu, Buddhism, Gandhi, Confucius, Taoism, Confucius. Right? Protestant religionists, Methodists, Baptists, Pentecostals. They're into legalism and goofy doctrines. Okay? I wanna read you something. I know it's a little off track here, but hey, you guys love me, right? Okay. I want to read you a little something, see if you get this, okay? Let's see if I can see it here. I want to read you something, okay? You're old? Yes. 70, all right? I want to read you something, okay? Right here, see it? Right there. I want to read you something. This is the words of Jesus. You look 100. Hey, I'll be there in 30 years. Okay. How old are you, if you don't mind me asking? 22, I'll bet. 24. 17. How old are you? All right, come on. How old are you? Hey, hi there, welcome. Welcome to the 0900 prayer request. Amen. This is a prayer request. How old are you, my friend? Come on. Come on back to me. This is the 0900 prayer request, right? We're right here in Missouri. Hi, Russia. We're in Missouri. You see this behind me? This is a Periscope map. And we're right here in Missouri, right there. That's St. Charles. That's right in the center of the United States. And these are all the places I've been going on Periscope. All right? Every day people have been coming to listen to the 0900 prayer request time. All right? I noticed my man didn't give me your age. Okay? All right? I'm going to read just a couple of lines here, what Jesus says about something. Do you like Russia? Amen. I love Russia. In Matthew, Jesus says, "Ye serpents, generation of vipers, how can you escape the damnation of hell?" In Luke, he says, Jesus does, "But I will forewarn you whom you shall fear. Fear him which after he hath killed hath power to cast into hell. Yea, I say unto you, fear him." Revelations, "And the devil that deceived them was cast into a lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire." In Matthew, "I say that whosoever is angry with his brother without a cause shall be in danger of judgment. Whosoever shall say to his brother, Raca, shall be in danger of the council. But whosoever will say, thou fool, shall be in danger of hell fire. And if thy..." Okay, and then we're going to go back down to Luke. "Fear him which hath killed hath power to cast into hell. Yea, I say unto you, fear him." In Luke 16, "And in hell he lift up his eyes, being in torment, and see Abraham afar off. And then the last one, in Peter, 2 Peter, for if God spared not the angels that sin, but cast them down to hell and delivered them into the chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment. Now, the question then, my friends out there in Periscope land, do you think that Jesus believed in hell? Mexico, hey, ¿cómo estás, amigo? Do you think that God, Jesus, do you think he believed in hell? Do you think what I just read from the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament? Muy bien. Excelente. Do you think that God, Jesus, believed in hell and talked about it in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament? All right? What do you think, people? Do you think that Jesus believed in hell? Did you hear what I just wrote? Did you hear what I just read? Amen? Do you think that Jesus believed there was a hell? Alright? Anybody got a comment there about that? Amen? Do you think that Jesus believed in hell? That's the question. Prayer request. 0900 prayer request. You talking to God, asking God for help in your life. The 0900 prayer request time. The question, do you think that Jesus believed in hell? An actual place of torment, a lake of fire. Do you think that Jesus believed it? 0900 prayer request time. I see you guys aren't answering, huh? Yeah, sure. That's right. He believed in hell. Now, hey, hi there. Welcome. Jesus, I just read you the words of Jesus, right? So now the question then, I believe that. Okay, amen. So the question, I get this. Ordinary, sane, sensible people. You read the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament words of Jesus, and this is in 5 different New Testament books and many other references also in the New Testament, that there is a place called hell, right? All right? So you can see and read with your own eyes the words of Jesus and say, yes, he says there's a hell, all right? Now, do you realize that there's a group of people called, and they're in Mexico too, Seventh-day Adventists. Seventh-day Adventists. They don't believe there's a hell. Okay? They do not believe in hell. This place that Jesus is talking to, this place of torment, fire and brimstone hell. That's right. Seventh-day Adventists don't believe that. Now, the Roman Catholic Church, Protestant churches, Islam, Hindus, Buddhists, animists, deists, and even atheists have their own belief systems. So, what is basically wrong with Protestant religionists? What's wrong with the Roman Catholics? What's wrong with Islam? What's wrong with Hinduism, Confucius, Buddhist, Gandhi followers? What's the biggest number one? What do they all have in common? What's the one thing of all these religions have in common? They are all guided by the devil, Satan. Okay? You know why I say that? Because all of the ones I just mentioned, without exception, refuse to do this. Repent. To become a spiritually born-again Christian, you got to understand grace, justification, and repentance. Repentance means to turn your life to the teachings of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. Now get this. There's no church tradition. There's no denominational writings. It's up to you, right there, you that are looking at me right now, you're going to read the Protestant Christian Bible truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. You will decide if you are going to follow Jesus. Okay? Now, if you want to run to a church house and sit there and let somebody try to explain to you what this or that means, and follow what that person that you don't know, if you want to follow his opinion or her opinion, that's your choice. But to be spiritually born again, you're going to have to understand grace, and you're justified through Jesus Christ alone, and you have to turn your life, you have to decide to follow the teachings and truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. You. Not what I say, not what some church tells you. You. You're going to read the words of Jesus. Mohammed is just like the Pope. It's just like Billy Graham. Mohammed is just like every spiritual leader. He's just like Gandhi. He's just like Buddha. You understand? It's a false religions out there. The Protestant religionists are false. The Roman Catholics are false. Mohammed, Islam, false. Buddhism, false. Pagan, false. Are they good moral teachers? Yes. But totally demonically controlled. You know why? Because they do not want to repent. They do not want to turn their private individual lives to the teachings of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. They each, all these religions, believe in their tradition, including the Protestant religionists, the Roman Catholic, Islam, Buddhist, da-da-da-da-da. They're in rebellion to God. They don't believe the Protestant Christian Bible truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. That's why we have over 4,000 religions in the world today of the 7 billion people. Let me tell you something. Before Islam was Christianity, and people refused to believe the letters written from the apostles in the whole Mediterranean, North African basin. That was all Christian at one time. But they decided, hey, we don't want to follow Jesus anymore. They give in to the sins of the flesh. Mohammed came into power. Why? To rebel against the Roman Catholics who had twisted their devil religion into control and power. Mohammed fought against that. And finally, Mohammed died, and his followers said, either you convert or we're going to kill you. And the whole holy wars and murderous things happened on this planet, all in the name of God. God had nothing to do with it. It was a devil. It's a devil today. It's going to be the devil tomorrow. Except you be born again. And you out there, you're going to decide individually if you want to believe in God's love and mercy, that Jesus is the only way of salvation, and that you agree to obey and follow the teachings of Jesus as you read it. Not by what some guy says. Stay away from that church house, or you'll become just another religionist. All right? That's the truth, folks. You got this idea to be a good person in life. You got to go to a church and be good. All right? There's none good except Jesus. And the only way you can be good with Jesus is if you repent and accept him as your Lord and Savior. But you got to want to repent. That means turn your life to his teachings, Not what you think you want your God to be like. Oh, no. Oh, no. So I started today's 0900 prayer request time with a question to the first group. Do you think God trusts you? And it goes right on. Do you think God trusts you? God trusts you. He gives it up to you. He doesn't force you to do anything. Your choice to follow God is going to be your choice. Nobody's going to make you do anything. 0900 prayer request time. It's about you guys out there in Periscope land talking to God. All right, look. Here's Periscope. This is where we've been now. Look at that. Isn't that something? All right, you can see our heart count up there. Let me help you here. Hey, hi there. Welcome. You can see here's our heart count as of yesterday. 52,300. And here's our views. 4,094. And that's just from this month. Around the last 6 weeks, maybe. All right, and you can see this is St. Charles, Missouri, right here, right in the center of the United States. And all these places is where people have commented and talked with us on the 0900 prayer request time. You can see this part here. This is all in Asia over here. All right. And these are all these countries I can't even pronounce, some of them. Kayakistan, Kyrgyzstan. Kazakhstan, India, Indonesia, all right, here we are, Australia, New Zealand, and come over here to the Middle East, and really, because we broadcast at 9 o'clock in the morning, it's nighttime over here, I mean early night, you know, 6, 7, 8 o'clock at night in the Middle East, and so we have a lot of contact with Russia, Norway, Sweden, all right, here's the UK, Scotland, England, everything in the UK. All right, then we got into Europe. Here's all of our countries again. Just look at this. All over, everywhere. Italy, just everywhere. We come right down through, this is North Africa, the Mediterranean, Israel, everywhere. Dubai, Ethiopia, just keeps going down. South Africa. Then we come over into Brazil, South America, all right? Oh, man, what is this one? Colombia, Puerto Rico, all right? Right here, Dominican Republic, Mexico, all right? All from this center place right here. This is the 0900 prayer request time. And it has nothing to do with anything. I'm not pushing any kind of religion. If anything, I'm telling you, stay away from that church or you'll just become another lost religionist. Meaningless, okay? You gotta serve the Lord. That means you in the Lord Jesus, you're going to have to want to serve Jesus. And you can't do it, not unless you're born again, all right? So how are you going to be spiritually born again? You're going to have to understand these things right here. Grace, justification, and repentance. Grace is God's power, strength, love, and favor to all people. You understand? God loves everyone. Sent Jesus for everyone. Stay away from these religions. They just separate you from the people. And you just end up believing what they believe. When you become a Protestant Christian, when you become spiritually born again, folks, it's you deciding you're going to obey the Protestant Christian Bible truths of Jesus, the Apostle. I got all this experience and I know more than you and Don't believe it. Stay away from everybody. Just get alone with the Lord and read the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. Don't go running to somebody and say, oh, please tell me what this means. I'm so dumb, I can't understand. Don't do it. Don't do it. The plain, simple truths of the Protestant Christian Bible are what you're held accountable for, and you'll understand. It's not difficult. Praise the Lord. It's not difficult. If you're married and you say, oh, okay, wife, I love you, and you go out holding around with some other woman, hello, give me a break. Same way, if you say you're going to love God with all your mind, heart, and soul, and then you could care less, you sneak out of the back door and become a hypocrite, well, that's not loving God. Running around with another woman's not loving your wife. Hello? Be real. Be real. God sees you the way you are, man. He loves you, sent Jesus. You think God didn't give you the power to become spiritually born again? You don't think God gave you the power that you'd have the victory over sin? That you're more than a conqueror? God trusts you with His Word. If you read His Word, the Protestant Christian Bible Truths of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist, you're going to get saved and you're going to have the victory. But here's the catcher, man. Here's the part that all these religionists, Pentecostal, Charismatics, whatever you want to call them, Assemblies of God, everybody, they can't do this. They can't repent. Repent means to turn to obedience of the teachings of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist. You can go up to all these religionists in the Protestant faith, all of them without exception. Matter of fact, you could go up to all these different religionists and you could say this one thing. Just like Jesus said, you want to follow me? They'll say, oh yeah, Lord, I believe you, Jesus. I believe in the Bible. And what did Jesus say? Go. Give away what you got and come follow me. And what them folks do? Ooh, man, I can't go that far. Ooh, adios, Jesus. What's a good LGBT church? You're in it now. You're in the world of sin. You understand, the LGBT church is the current Protestant religion church. Okay? Alright? it's part of the sin-filled world. And you fit, the people of LGBT fit right in because they're in sin just like everybody else. Mind you, you don't go to hell for being a transvestite, for being a lesbian, sodomite, pedophile, sexual deviant. You don't go to hell for that. You don't go to hell for being a murderer, an adulterer, bank robber, rapist, pedophile. You don't go to hell for that. You understand? All of that can be forgiven. There's consequences for all of that, but you can be forgiven. The reason people go to hell, this place of fire and brimstone, just like there's a place called heaven, streets of gold and jasper walls, is because they refuse to what? Repent. They refuse to turn their life to, now look, repent doesn't mean stop doing something. Repent means, oh, sorry, sorry, wrong chart. Repentance means to turn your life to the teachings of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. That, along with understanding grace, justification only through Jesus, and repentance. That's it. God loves everybody, sent Jesus for everybody. Amen. 0900 prayer request time. Talking to God, that's what it's all about. Prayer is talking to God. You are accountable for you. Nobody else. It's not a subject. Oh, well, what about these people over here? What about this group? What about... No. Irregardless, you have nothing to do with these other people. The gospel message of salvation is only for you that's hearing my voice and looking right at me right now. You guys right there. You millennials. Generation X, you're looking at me. You can run, but you can't hide. You see that map behind me? Look at that. You see all them places right in the center of St. Charles, Missouri. That's where I'm at, right? And I've been broadcasting only for about 6 weeks from right here every day, 9 o'clock. And I've had conversations with all these different people around the world, especially down through the Middle East, because I broadcast in the morning and it's evening time there. People here in the United States are working. All right? And what's it all about? It's all about one thing. Look here, man. It's only about this. Grace, justification, and repentance. I'm not selling a book. I don't want you to join a church. You join a church, that's about the worst thing you can do. You understand? When you get right with the Lord, it's going to be between you and the Lord. There's nobody else involved. Don't believe this hoodoo talk that you got to go to some church house to become a Christian. Don't believe it. You go to that church house, you're just going to become a puppet like they are. You're going to sit there and end up being nothing but a lost religionist. Don't go to them church houses. Don't go to them assemblies of God. Don't go to them. Don't, for sure. Just stay away. Here's how you handle going to a church. I've said this many times. It's like going to a family reunion. You know, son, you don't like going to family reunion or high school reunions or college reunions. You know, it might be a good idea, but then you see somebody and all of a sudden, you're remembering stuff. Well, that's the way it is when you go to a church house. So don't be going to that church house. Go there about once every 6 months or once a year. That's about all you need. But in between time, how often does your church have LGBT prayers? what a joke. All right. 0900 prayer request time. Amen. 0900 prayer request time. It's about you, what? Talking to God. All right. 0900 prayer request. You asking God to help you in your life. No more, no less. Are you able today to talk to God? Are you unbelieving? Are you angry at God? Do you resent God? Do you love God? Do you appreciate God? Do you think He doesn't exist? Have you been running from God? 0900 prayer request time. It's about you. 0900 is 9 o'clock in the morning. It's military time. 0900. Today is this is 26th March, Saturday morning in where? In Missouri. And that's where it is on this periscope map behind me. Right there in the center. That's St. Charles, Missouri. And those are all the places that we reached out through periscope. You can see all through the Middle East, and that's, I really enjoy that. I mean, I thank God for that. Amen. This is about prayer. I started on the last of January, really. Started broadcasting daily. And tried to stay on this one subject so much, about prayer requests. It's about you talking to God. You understand it's going to be you talking to God. It's not going to be you thinking about this or da 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 da. Not talking or chatting to me or making statements to me. But it's about you praying to God. That's what it's about. Only you can talk to God. Only you. I can't talk for you. I can't do anything for you in that regard. You have a free will and you choose. But you got to talk. The Protestant Christian Bible New Testament truth tells us that one day everybody's going to kneel before Jesus. Better to do it on this side than on the other side, because the other side you're going to be standing before judgment. 0900 prayer request. Amen? So why not talk to the Lord? One day you're going to begin. You know how at the job, or at school or gym class or whatever, wherever you're at, and you always want to go talk to a person and you never went out and talked to that person because you're a little shy or timid. And so you wanted to, but you never went to that person and talked to them. You wanted to, but you didn't. Prayer. Talk to God. I guarantee you, you talk to God, God's going to talk back to you. And here's the way it works, guys. Now listen. All right, here's the way it works. You want to talk to God? You get alone somewhere. I mean, get alone. Get in your car. Go for a walk. All right? Then, I want you to begin to think about the Lord, right? And then all these thoughts are going to be coming at you. Oh, I got to do this at work. I got to get this done. Oh, this is silly what I'm doing. God's not going to talk to me. You're being ridiculous. Dada. All these thoughts, you're going to have to push them out, right? And just say, no, I'm going to communicate with God. All right? And you're going to stop those thoughts for a moment in time. And you can do it. Just be quiet. Be still before the Lord. And wherever it is, walk in or in your car or in your room. It just doesn't matter. Wherever you can get quiet. And then you got to stop your mind from racing and going 1,000 miles an hour about every thought you can think. Just stop. And you talk to the Lord. And whatever it is that you need to ask the Lord about, whether he's real or about this or about that, you talk to him. And here's what's going to happen. This is a guarantee. This isn't maybe. When you get alone, you get quiet, you get still before the Lord, you ask what you need to ask the Lord at that time. And he's going to speak back to you, not in an audible voice, but in your mind and in your heart. He's going to give to you his reply. Okay? I'm going to read you something about the LGB community. Alright? Hold on a second. See if I can find it here. I got a new book here, man. Alright? And this one, I've had so many verses and different things that people ask me just here on this that I've had to make a little file, and the little file's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. All right. This is something that I put together right here. Single space. I'm going to read to you this. This is about the LGBT communities. All right. For me, homosexuality is just like Roman Catholicism. It's just like Islam. What are you trying to? Hello, hi. What are you trying to? What's the name of the website you're trying to go to? All right, let's put it that way. Are you putting howtobecomeachristiantoday.com? Is that what you're doing, or what is the website? Your website. Oh yeah, sure. Okay. All right, hold on. I'll show you easy. I have three domain names here. Let me show you this one. Here it is. Hold on. Got it right here, my friend. Look here. Here you go. These three will get you there. All right. How to become a Christian today.com or Norman Etker one word .com or Hmongnews.org. It all goes to the same thing. Or you can Google my name. We're on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter. Alright? Our website. If you look on Periscope at our who we are on Periscope, you see the link too. No, you don't have to use capital. But make sure, you can't hear, the quickest way is normanetker.com. Okay? normanetker.com. All one word, no spaces. Norman Etker. All one word. All lowercase. All right? That'll work. You'll get there. You Google my name, you'll see it. Okay? This is about homosexuals. You still there, my friend? You out there? Can you prove that Jesus is good, sir? Can I prove that he's good or God? God. Okay? Yeah, that's easy enough. I know this is going to be a simple answer, but right there's the answer. Because he said so. Right there. He said it, so I believe it. Okay, I know that's kind of a simple Simon answer, but that's just how simple you got to be loving people. If you love your wife, you love your baby dolls, and you don't believe they're lying to you. All right. Here's the thing about homosexuality. I wrote this part myself, but I'm going to read you a little bit later. I'm going to read this part first, this right here. Single space. And it doesn't take long, about 2 minutes. And then I'm going to read you this little line, this little paragraph here. Okay? This is about homosexuals, lesbians, transvestite, cross-genders, pedophiles, bestiality, incest. They're all involved in abnormal sexual behavior. They're all related. Okay, homosexual, lesbians, transgender, pedophile, incest, bestiality, abnormal sexual relations, they're all related. Pedophilia. Hey, hi, Turkey. So here we go. Listen to this. This is what I wrote, and then I'll read you that last part, okay? Homosexuals. Sexual practices describes an individual's characteristics as the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament states. And let me say this. Okay. Good comment. That's right. Jesus is good. Now, in the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament Truths of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist, we hear references to sin, murder, stealing, things like that, okay? And also it talks about homosexuality too, lesbians, you know, all the pedophilia, everything, all related, bestiality, incest, they're all grouped together with homosexuality. Now, so they're grouped together, but the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament goes into great detail talking about the character of people that are enslaved to these abnormal sexual practices. Pedophilia, incest, bestiality, homosexual, lesbian, transgender, okay? it talks about the character of these people. And it's the only subject in the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament that it goes in great detail to explain the character of people that practice these. Now listen. This first part is by me, and then I'm going to read you the second part, okay? Please. This is about these people. Seeking out and practicing abnormal sexual relationships. Practice sexual acts on each other, women with women and men with men. Those who seek out and practice this abnormality suffer within themselves. Their practical lives increase in attaining more wickedness. These individuals seek out more sins to do. They become hoarders and their personal greed abounds. Hate grows increasingly within their lives. Jealousy is their common bedfellow as they are involved with others. Murder is acceptable within their lives. Quarreling is their conversation. Deceiving others continually is normal practice. Mean and vindictive behaviors towards others is the common thread uniting. Gossiping replaces normal conversations. Gaining your friendship only to deceive. They not only reject God, they hate God and God followers. Arrogance towards all others. Pride and boastful is their way of life. They invent new ways to commit acts of sin sexually or otherwise. They're consumed with no respect for their parents or other senior elders. They refuse to understand the plain truths of any subjects. They say and promise with the full knowledge of not fulfilling. Within their private lives, there is no compassion or mercy. They fully understand the wrongs against society that they commit personally, morally, and ethically, and can be held accountable for their actions, private and publicly. The men and women, the practitioners of the above-described actions, know full well the harm that they bring upon themselves and to all others within society. However, they continue willfully without any shame or regret and further encourage others to do the same. Now I want to read you this little short little thing right here. This is from the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. I'm sure you've read this. Romans 1. 27:29-32. The Bible states, Protestant Christian Bible New Testament, and the men, instead of having normal sexual relations with women, burn with lust for each other. Men did shameful things with other men, and as a result of this sin, they suffered within themselves the penalty they deserved. Their lives become full of every kind of wickedness, sin, greed, hate, envy, murder, quarreling, deception, malicious behavior, and gossip. Verse 30, they are backstabbers, haters of God, insolent, proud, and boastful. They invent new ways of sinning. They disobey their parents. They refuse to understand, break their promises, are heartless, and have no mercy. They know God's justice requires that those who do these things deserve to die. Yet they do them anyway. Worse yet, they encourage others to do them too. Now, before you write anything, before you say anything, listen to this. Endowed as a Protestant Christian, spiritually born-again Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ, thou shalt love the Lord, this is in Mark, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first command. And, in Luke, thy neighbor as thyself. For God sent not his Son into the world, in John, to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. So, for me, when you read about the characteristics of these sexually abnormal people, if you don't have compassion for their twisted up lives, then you're really not a spiritually born again Christian. These people, as well as all people, the Roman Catholic, the religious Protestants, Islam, Buddhists, Hindu, all people of the world that say they're Christian, they really are not, because they refuse to what? They refuse this one thing, my friends out there. The people, the religious people of the world, refuse to repent. Repent means to turn your life to and obey the teachings of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist in the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. Not what a church teaches, not what a denomination teaches, but what you read in the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. Not what somebody else says, but what you read the words of Jesus. You out there, nobody else. You're only accountable for your actions, not by what you think my opinion about something is. No. You're only going to be judged by what? The words of Jesus. All right, that's it, my friends. You're going to read it. Don't run to that church house. You're going to read the words of Jesus, and either you're going to obey Jesus or you're not going to obey. You're going to be condemned. You know that no liar, fornicator, murderer is going to heaven, because that's what the Bible says. No matter how many churches embrace him, say, oh, everything's fine, come on. No, it doesn't work like that. Because you're listening to the philosophy of men. The Protestant Christian Bible New Testament, you're going to have to be judged on that. And only you. And it's not by some book you're going to read about it. All right? You're going to read the very words. And you're going to see. And you're going to decide what you want to do. All right, guys. So that's that. I've said that many times, read that many times so far on the 0900 prayer request. Hey, this is about the prayer request. Look here, this is Periscope back here in the back. Okay, you see that? This is right here where I'm pointing. This is in Missouri. This is right here in Missouri, right there. St. Charles, right? You can see that's where we're at, and that's where this center point is, right there. And we've been broadcasting. You can see our hearts up there and views. This has only been for about 6 weeks. All right? And we've had conversations with most of these people right there that's come on. All right? It's about this, folks. It's about this only. It's not about me. It's not about anything else. It's about loving the Lord Jesus. It's about praying. It's about talking to God. Right? That's all it is, talking to God. Oh, 900 prayer requests. Amen? It's about you talking with God. All right? What is the Protestant Christian Bible? The Protestant Christian Bible is this. The Protestant Christian Bible is our current English Bible. It was translated in around 1500. That's when England sent out these historians, these linguists, to all around the Mediterranean basin area, North Africa, Spain, Portugal, Italy, West Asia, and gathered up together the first century writings of the apostle and those that were written about Jesus. These letters, these books that we have now in our current Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. All these countries in the Mediterranean area took those original letters from the first and second century and they translated into their many different dialects and languages around the world. It was in the 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th century that England, being a world ruler, sent these historians around to all of these different areas in the Mediterranean basin and collated all these different letters and retranslated them out of their local dialects from the Greek into the current English language. And they found that all of these early letters from all different parts of the Mediterranean area all were saying the same thing. And that composes our Protestant Christian Bible. Not the Roman Catholic Vulgate edition, but the Protestant. This is the truth. This is the only word that came down from Christ. This junk about Peter being the first pope and all, that's fairyland stuff. You believe that? You don't believe it, folks. You check it out. Go to your local library. You'll find it's just humbug. It's just another belief system. That's all. Just like Hindu, Islam, just fairyland beliefs, myths and fables. This is the actual stuff. And what makes this different? Because this Protestant Christian Bible is the only one that can do this supernatural thing in your life. None of these other religions can do it. This Protestant Christian Bible truths about grace, justified through Jesus alone, and turning your life to the truth and teachings of Jesus alone. When you agree to do that, then God, if you're willing to give up the right to yourself to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and become His servant, God will supernaturally come into your life and trance will change. Will create the transformation process within you. Will be complete. You'll become a new creature in Christ Jesus. There's no other religion can do that. You'll just be converted to whatever religion it is. There's only one that has a regenerating power from the holiness of God, and that's in the Protestant Christian Bible truths of Jesus. But you, this is the part that all these religionists can't do. They can't give up the right to themselves to obey just Jesus, His truths from the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. No, they got their own writings. They got their own doctrine. They got their own traditions because they make their God just the way they want it to be. The Roman Catholics, the Protestant religionists, the Pentecostals, the Messianics, Hindu, organized religion, they just make it, they pick and choose what they want their God to be like. It doesn't work, folks. What is the true church? The true church is the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. And guess what? Only you can decide if you want to be a Christian. There's nobody else involved, guys. This church pastor, you think you can recite some little prayer, a sinner's prayer, and you're a Christian, you believe in Jesus, you're going to say he's your Lord and Savior, you're going to be water baptized, name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost in water. You think you'll go to the church and pay tithes and believe everything the preacher man tells you and you're a Christian? You're in hoodoo land. It's not real. You're just another religionist. To be spiritually born again, you're going to have to understand grace. Justification, grace is God's power, strength, and love to all one. Grace helps you to understand about God. Without grace, you can't do it. If you think you can decide to be a Christian, it's just like I've said many times, just because you go to a McDonald's restaurant, eat them Big Macs, don't make you a Big Mac. It's the same thing. You can go to that church house all you want. It's not going to make you a Christian. It's not about anybody else. It's only about you. You right there looking at me right now in your little smartphone. It's about you. You're the only one that can make that decision. It's not going to be based on what somebody writes in a book somewhere or what you hear someone else say. You're going to get along with God one day in your life. That's right. You're going to get sincere with the Lord. It's between you and the Lord. There's nobody else involved, folks. Nobody. Nobody. You're going to read the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. You're going to read it. You're going to understand it. You. You're not going to go run to the bookstore and buy a book to try to understand what this means. No. You're going to reason and understand with your own mind. You know why? Because God didn't make any junk. God will help you at your level to understand exactly what God wants you to know in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. You don't need anyone else to do anything. The Holy Scripture says the Holy Spirit in Luke 12:12 will teach you and bring all things to your remembrance. But if your belief is not in the Protestant Christian Bible truths of Jesus the Apostle and Evangelist, if your truths are based on what somebody's going to tell you, teach you in some kind of Sunday school class, then you're bound for failure. You're doomed for failure over and over. You're just going to be another lost religionist doing nothing for nothing for nothing and paying out money every week to something so that you can keep doing nothing and nothing and nothing. You think God can't see you phony baloney religionists out there? God sees you just the way you are. But God's immaculate holy grace is going forth to what? To the people that don't know how to become a Christian. You phony baloney religionists are going to stay in the background. Because God's love and grace is greater than the evil you perpetrate through your phony churches of religious Christianity. It's not real. And God wants that grace and justification and repentance message of how to become a new creature in Christ to keep going out to all the people of the world. All 7 billion people of the world. Religious Christianity is a farce, a joke. It's a sham. God knows it. And you guys that are religionists, you know it too. It's not real. You're playing a religious church game. Grace, justification, and repentance. Amen? This is the 0900 prayer request time. Right? What is prayer? Prayer is talking to God. My name's Norman Edgar. I'm a Protestant Christian missionary. Where am I located? You might ask. I'm located right here in Missouri, right there. I'm 70. My wife Selma's 68. You can see our little periscope map behind us here. Here we are. Amen. We've been up for about 6 weeks. You can see here in the center of the United States, that's right where we're at. And we've been broadcasting all into these areas. All these red strings you see going to these markers are people we have been in contact with for the last 6-8 weeks. They ask questions and they're part of this 0900 prayer request time. All over in the Middle East, where all this evil is, you hear on the news. Southeast Asia, Indonesia, all these Muslim areas. God loves the world. He sent Jesus for the world, not just for some little hand-picked group of people. And God's message is moving on to all the people of the world, not this phoniness that's called Christian religion today. It's just that. It's phony. It's not real. You see little five-second clips on TV here in Missouri. Jesus loves you. Duh. What good's that going to do? It's just an ad promotion for you to come to their church and you pay them some money. They got a love doctrine. God loves you. God loves you. You don't have to do nothing. Just come as you are. Wear shower shoes and dirty old filthy clothes. God loves you. We love you too. You understand? But if you want to go to a job interview, you'll get dressed up and look nice. You want to go on a date with a woman, you'll get dressed up. If you, a woman, want to go on a date with a guy, you'll get dressed up and look nice, hair fixed up. But we got signs all over here in Missouri. Come dressed as you are. You could go, I've watched people in their PJs. This is no joke. You see them going to the store here not wearing pajamas. And they'll trot right into the stores wearing pajamas. They'll trot right into the church house doing the same thing. Skin tight clothes, you can just see, just it's terrible. I just. And they got a milk toast. It's just. They ought to be ashamed, but they're not. Do you understand? Prayer requests. They don't teach the Bible. They teach 101 psychology. And people love it. Oh, God's not going to judge me. Oh, I'm good, man. Well, I know I'm living with this guy. I know it's right. Hey, I went to a church one time. The woman, door greeter at the door. Door greeter. This is Assembly of God Church. Was a door greeter. And she was shacked up with a guy. Wasn't her husband shacked up with a guy. The pastor and everybody in the church house knew it. And she was the door greeter, greeting people coming in. You tell me. Anything goes. Just come to the church house. 0900 prayer request time. Amen. Hey, hi there. Welcome to the 0900 prayer request time. This is going to be recorded, everything on here. So you might be wondering if you don't see anybody else chit-chatting in here. It's because these are recorded and they come on our website, howtobecomeachristiantoday.com. All right, that's on our website. And we have that. Okay. And you can see that. NormanEtker.com, howtobecomeachristiantoday.com. All right? This is the 0900 prayer request time. It's about you asking God for prayer. I'm a Protestant Christian missionary. If I asked you about Islam, what are you going to say? That Islam, okay, I'll tell you what I'm going to say. Islam is just like Roman Catholic and religious Protestants. They're just like Buddhists and just like Hindus, animists, atheists, deists. They're all the same. It's just a lost religion. That's all. Just like Protestant Christian religionists, Roman Catholic, Islam, Mohammed, Buddha. Okay? They're just lost religionists. God did what? What did God do, my friend? Look, listen to this. Listen. God sent his son Jesus into the world. Right? God sent Jesus into the world to condemn the world? No, but that the world through him might be saved. The Christian religionists aren't saved. The Roman Catholics aren't saved. Islam, not saved. Buddhists, not saved. Hindus, not saved. They're religionists, good, morally good, decent people for the most part. But they're not saved. I don't know what that means, that statement, but all right, look, it's the 0900 prayer requests. My name's Norman Edgar. I'm a Protestant Christian missionary. What is a Protestant Christian missionary? A Protestant Christian missionary is one that only believes in the Protestant Christian Bible. The Protestant Christian Bible was first translated into English in 1500. The Protestant Christian Bible came from the entire Mediterranean basin that was Christian from the latter part of the first century of the Christian era to the second century. England in 1500, 1600. Okay. These letters were all correlated from the first writings of the first and second century. They remained in the Protestant Christian Mediterranean region. I'm going to show you something if I can. A little difficult to see because of this map. Let me get a different map here to show you something. A lot of people don't know this. The followers of Islam, the followers of Roman Catholicism, the followers of Protestant religionists, they really aren't. They don't want to do the research and check anything out. They just spoon fed and believe what people say to them. Okay, that's all. All right, I want to show you something. Now, this little map here is a little version. I like you, so sorry for asking. Forget that. Okay, I don't know what that means either. Okay, look here. This here is a map, right? This is the Mediterranean here, right in here, right? Now, this whole thing about Jesus started right in this area, right in here, right? Okay? So, the Apostle Paul is missionary. This is Africa, Northern Africa, right? All this over here. We got Spain, France, Portugal, all this. Here's our European countries, all right? Here's Italy coming back around. Here's Asia. Paul and his missionary journeys in the first century went to all these different places, all right? And these people heard what the Apostle Paul was saying. Plus, there was Jews that came once a year to Jerusalem and heard the message of the Apostle Peter talking. That was the Jews. Came from Italy. That's how they got to Rome. This thing about the Pope and all that, that's baloney. Don't believe it. So, here, this message spread all through this Mediterranean region, all around this. So, they took the letters that were written to the individual family group, little families that were meeting in people's houses, and they saved those letters written in Greek at that time. And you understand that they, the people of these regions, translated those letters into their own dialects and languages. All right? So each little group in each part of the world had their own little letters and documents relating back to the second and first century of the Christian era. All right? So then, when the dominating power of England happened up here, they sent historians, this is in the 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th century, they sent historians and linguists who went around all these different religious Christian sites and gathered from those ancient churches the writings that they had stored and kept throughout the millennia and centuries, okay? They then collated all of those back and looked at the writings of these groups of people. Okay? And they come to find out that all of these letters, when they translate them back to English, they were all basically saying the same essential truths that we have today. Now, just on an intellectual level, that's a miraculous thing. Because traveling to all these different parts of the world, very few people did. All right? There's no internet, there's no newspapers, there's no nothing, right? So when they translated these, and I, myself, have, right behind this map, books with copies of these different texts that they found. This is not based on the Vulgate, the Latin Vulgate writings. It's based on the Protestants researching this entire area around the Mediterranean basin. That's where our Protestant Christian Bible comes from. From these writings from the first and second centuries. And in the Library of London, they have the actual copies. And I have the guy who was the librarian. He wrote 6 volumes about this, and he copied these so that you can see the actual transcripts. Okay? His name, Thomas Hartwell Horn. That's where the Protestant Christian Bible comes from. All right? Now, that was from the first century and second century. All right? And within 400 years, Rome was the center of the world. They were the world power. And the Jews that heard about what Peter said in his first preaching, Peter, in the book of Acts, they were in Jerusalem celebrating. They had to come every year. They returned to Rome. These Jews, after hearing about Jesus, they started a church. But Rome was so strong and powerful, they brought other gods. Every conquered nation, they bring the gods there. So these Jewish people who heard about Jesus at first were following Jesus, but soon thereafter created a religion based on power and control because they were Rome. And Rome had the power. And Jews at that one time were still authenticated and recognized by the Romans. And they were allowed to do what they were doing. But not each century. It all changes as centuries go along. But at that time, so that's how they gained the power and control over other people, by the sheer force of the Roman army. This happened for 300 or 400 years. They destroyed any Roman Catholic people that followed this false religion, destroyed anybody that opposed him. This is what Mohammed wrote about and was disgusted with, and he copied the writings of the Protestant, Christian, Jewish Old Testament from the Septuagint. And he created a book called the Quran. He just wrote anything that came to his mind. His followers after him decided, well, here's what you're going to do. Convert or die. And that's what they did. They murdered anybody who got in their way. And the doctrine that Mohammed wrote clearly justifies it. All right? Roman Catholicism was evil. Islam is evil. They murder and kill. The Church of England in the Holy Wars, they killed and murdered everybody in the name of God. They're all evil people. That's not God. It's not Jesus. It's a bunch of people wanting power and control over another nation. It's that simple. Don't ever believe this garbage about Islam, Roman Catholics, or Protestant religionists, that they're good, God-fearing, Judeo-Christian people in the United States. Don't believe it. Well, they say the same thing about Buddha, the same thing about the Pope. It's okay. You're entitled to believe anything you want to believe, but facts remain. You're a history denier. Okay, that's all. That's history. If you want to live in make-believe land, let me tell you something. Let me tell you one better than that. You think that Mohammed guy is a sharp dude? Let me tell you. A guy named Giovanni Ferretti in 1870. You know who Giovanni Ferretti in 1870? You know who he was? He was a guy that started a religious movement. Giovanni Ferretti, 1870 in Italy, started a religious movement. He decided that he could never make a mistake. He's kind of like this Mohammed guy, right? He's kind of like Buddha. Buddha, Mohammed, and this Ferretti guy, all equal, all right? Well, this Giovanni Ferretti in Italy in 1870 said he could never make a mistake regarding religion. He was like a god. This Giovanni Ferretti in 1870 said, I am going to make this sinful woman named Mary a god that you can pray to. That's right. This demon-inspired people, Giovanni Ferretti, was Pope Pius IX. Demon-inspired people refused to believe the Protestant Christian Old Bible, Old Testament prophecies about Jesus being the Messiah 200 years before Christ came. This Mohammed guy decided to write his own book the way he wanted it to be. Buddha heard the same truth about Jesus. He decided to climb a tree for 3 days and get enlightenment. You got people worshiping cows, rats, and monkeys. You got people in the United States, American women have murdered their own babies, 50 million plus, and they all say they're from a Judeo-Christian country. Don't believe all this stuff. There's only one truth, my friends, and that's the truth of Jesus. You have a question? 0900 prayer request time. It's about talking to God. The Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. That's the only book that guarantees you a new life in Christ. The only one that can make you a new creature in Christ. You understand? It's a regeneration process that happens instantaneously. When Jesus becomes your Lord and Master. These others, you bow down to Sharia law, bow down to Roman Catholicism, bow down. Okay? To become a spiritually born again Christian, what do you need? How can you do it? To become a spiritually born again Christian, you have to understand these three things. Well, that's right, there's no God. That's right. Nobody created Jesus. He always was. Grace. Justification and repentance. For you to become a Christian, The Holy Spirit. But I think you understand. Yes, I understand what you're writing. And you are wrong. Okay? Look, I see what you're writing. Okay? But you're wrong. And so, yes, Mary existed. I respect you. You're just, I'm sorry. You know something, you can respect all you want, but it doesn't make any difference. That's a fairy tale. Yes. I know, that's what people think about the Bible. It's a fairy tale. Not good at all. Yes, I know. That's what people think. Okay, I'm on board with you about it, my friend. Okay? Good religious people are going to hell. Morally good, decent, law-abiding, tax-paying, loving, kind people are going to hell. All right? Why are people going to hell? Going to heaven, going to hell. There's two. There's no purgatory. There's no place in between. I've no doubt that Jesus was dark-skinned. There's no doubt about it. Grace, justification, and repentance. That's how you become a spiritually born-again Christian. You're going to have to understand grace. You're going to have to understand justification. You're going to have to understand repentance. Then you will decide. Not because of what you've been spoon-fed since you're a little boy in school or church or temple or whatever. You can get down on your knees and pray 5 times, 10 times. You can take a bead on a string and pray one right after another all day long. You can be a denier. Anything. What are the points behind your back? Hey, okay, glad you asked, my friend. This is Periscope. This is what's been happening for the past 6 weeks. My wife Selma and I've been on. I come on every day at 9 o'clock. I'm a Protestant Christian missionary. We're located right here in Missouri, right here, St. Charles. And these are all the places, especially this. I like this. Look here. This is the Middle East. This is where the false Islamic religion is practiced a lot. All this whole area where Islam is used to be Christian. But when Islam took over in 600 AD, this Mohammed guy, his followers decide to kill anybody who didn't join their faith. And that's why we have 1 billion Muslims today, is because they're afraid of being killed or tortured by other Muslims. That's just historical fact. Go to any library you want, read it. You'll see it. I didn't make it up. So, this is where we've been. We're all over. I have contact with all these people. All right? You can see over here, Asia, India, everywhere. Japan, all right? Indonesia, Australia, New Zealand, all right? And this is our heart count today, from yesterday, 52,307. And we've had 4,000 views, that's of yesterday. And that is just in the last 6 weeks or so. All right? This is the 0900 prayer request. It's about you talking. I don't represent a church because I know the religious churches of today are phony balonies. All right? I don't mind telling you that, okay? You count it all. That's right. Amen. Do you know why I count it? Look here. Do you know why I count it? About 8 or 9 years ago, the Lord spoke to my heart. Okay? The reason I count it is the Lord spoke to my heart about 8 or 9 years ago that the ministry, I've been a Protestant Christian missionary for 40 years. 5 missionary tours in Southeast Asia and 7 years just now returned from Mexico. Said, your ministry will be like a wheel. spokes of a wheel. Okay? Right here. Spokes of a wheel going out. You don't have the problem. Okay, you don't. Okay, look, guys. Look. You're making something real simple difficult. Okay? Okay, look, guys. Look. I'm Arabic, by the way. Yeah, I know you guys. Look. I'm going to show you something. Just hold on a second. I'm going to show you something. Just bear with me a minute. Just hang in there, guys. Don't freak out on me. Stay with me. Okay? Alright. Now look, you see this? I'm going to show you again. See this little sign I always put up? Grace, justification, repentance. What is grace? Grace is God's power, strength, love, and favor to all people. 2016, all 7 billion or so people on the planet. Grace. God condescends down to us and helps us to understand about Him. Grace. You have to understand grace. You have to believe in grace. You can't choose to be a Christian by doing some legalistic thing, praying, saying things, okay? No, it isn't. You're wrong. Grace doesn't make you live right. Now look, okay? Now I want you to read that. Okay, can you read that? This is from the book of Ephesians, right? For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourself, it is the gift of God. You cannot do anything to become a spiritually born-again Christian. Okay? You cannot do anything to become a spiritually born-again Christian. Hey, hi there, welcome. Grace. Alright? For you to be able to pray to God, you have to talk to God. All right. It's sort of like an example could be if you're married, right? If you're married to let's say you guys you're married to a woman, right? And so you go to another woman and you tell this other woman what you think about something, and you don't go back to your wife and tell her the same thing. So you're living one life with your wife and you find another life that you talk with and share with another woman. You know that you should be talking to your wife about everything, but you found it more easier to talk to this other woman that you're not married to about everything. All right. In that example, God instead of you talking to God, you run around to these other religions and talk to them, and you believe what they said. You're just repeating what someone has drilled down into your head. Okay. You're only repeating what someone has taught you is religion that you should believe. The religionists aren't people going to heaven. Islamic people aren't going to heaven. Roman Catholic people aren't going to heaven. Protestant religionists aren't going to heaven. You know why? Because they don't believe in Jesus. They got an idea about Jesus. They got an idea about the Quran. They got an idea about Buddha. They got an idea of the Protestants, how they want their God to be like. And they all believe it. Because I see it all day long here on Periscope, what people believe. But it's meaningless. You have to understand. You're not going to be judged on the Bible. You're going to be judged only on one thing. The truth of the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament of Jesus. Those truths. The Protestant Christian Bible New Testament truths of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist. That's repentance. It's not head knowledge. Repentance means that you turn your life. Repentance means that you turn your life to the teachings of Jesus, the Apostle and Evangelist, in the Protestant Christian Bible New Testament. You. All right? You have to make that decision. You can read everything. You can read the whole thing. You can quote the scripture. It doesn't make any difference. You understand, grace enables you to understand. You can't understand. All right? Grace. What is grace? Grace enables you because God condescends down to you to help you to understand this spiritual substance that we call God. Grace. Okay? Yes, thank you for your comment about John. Well, who do you think created Jesus in the womb? Grace helps us to understand. God enables us to understand this spiritual substance called God. He condescends down to us to help us to understand. You cannot understand God without grace helping you, because it's grace that enables you to understand about God. This is why this doctrine of grace is so important. This is the bedrock. Grace does away with this legalism that you have to do this, do that, do this, believe that. You understand, in grace, you're perfectly innocent. Grace is innocent. All right? Grace enables you to understand about God, to begin to understand God. The first precept, the first line of Genesis, grace helps you. God helps you to understand. Now, that's just forget about all your old religious stuff here a minute and read this again. Look at that again. It's by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourself. It's a gift from God. Not from yourself. Okay? Now, grace. Now, the next thing you're going to begin to understand is what they call justification. All right? Justification. Grace is going to help you to believe that God created the world. Everything that you see, from the dateless past to the dateless future, all universes known and unknown. God created it all. God created man and woman. All right? Thank you for your comment about Mohammed. Justification. Grace helps you to understand everything that God said he did. Grace helps you to understand the story of disobedience by Adam and Eve. How sin entered in. How the Adam and Eve now brought original sin that passed down to all people. You begin to understand that now because of grace. Hey, good. Thank you. You're welcome to return anytime. 0900 prayer request time every day, 0900, okay? Central Standard Time in the U.S. Justification. Genesis 3:15, God said, I'm going to send one in the future that's going to crush the power of evil over your life. All right, good. Have a good evening. You too. Thank you very much. Thank you also. See you. You bet. Amen. Justification. Justification. All right. Justification. By grace, you're able to understand that the one that God promised Adam and Eve in Genesis 3:15 came in fact through Jesus, who was born of a virgin, conceived by the Holy Spirit of God. A sinful woman named Mary was conceived by the Holy Spirit of God. She found favor with God. Okay? So now we understand grace, God condescending down to us. God's grace helps us to understand how we're justified, how we can return to God only through one guy, Jesus, who was a what? God-man. He atoned for all the sins of the world. Sin requires justification before God. Sin deserves punishment. It's called God's wrath. A man could not take upon himself the sins, total sins of the world from the past, the present, and the future. That's why Jesus was a God man. Conceived by the Holy Spirit of God. He knew his purpose was to do that. Okay? Thank you for your comment. That's right. Luke 12:12. The Holy Ghost shall teach you all things and bring all things to remembrance. Justification. We are justified by Jesus. So now, grace helps us to understand creation. Grace helps us to understand that we can be reconciled, we can be justified to God, be reconciled with God through the atonement of Jesus and Jesus alone. All right? There's one. Here's two. Now, here's number three. Here's where everybody, including a lot of people making comments here, fall down flat about this one thing. Repentance. The religious Bible thumpers will thump that Bible and put out those chat messages, boom, 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 boom. But you can always tell they don't understand this one word. Repentance. When you ask the Bible thumpers, what does repentance mean? You know what they're going to say? They're going to say, man, that means you got to turn from the world. You got to stop sinning, drugging, drinking, sexing, evil, lying, cheating, whatever. You got to repent of that. Stop doing that. Well, I got news for you. That's not what it means. Well, grace, justification, repentance doesn't mean stop. If you're going to become a Christian, of course you're going to stop doing evil. Hello. Repentance means to turn your life to obedience to the teachings and truths of Jesus, the apostles, and the evangelists in only the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament. All right. Thank you for your comment again. Repentance means to turn to the truths of Jesus, the apostle, and the evangelist in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament only. No other religion, no Roman Catholicism, no Protestant Christian denomination doctrines, no Mohammed doctrines, no Hindu doctrines, no nothing. Roman Catholicism is of the devil. Protestant religionists are lost, demonically motivated. Hindu, Islam, all of them, demonic in origin. You know why? This one word. It's called repentance. Repentance, when you understand grace, you understand justification, repentance means that you, there you, that's right, you in Periscope looking at me right now, you agree to turn your life to the teachings of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist, in the Protestant Christian Bible, New Testament only. There are no traditions. There are no doctrines apart from that. There's no doctrines written in harmony with this. There's no books written so that you can understand this. Do you understand it? That's bogus. It's a lie from the devil. Now, to become spiritually born again, you're going to have to understand grace, justification, and repentance. Now that you understand it, you got head knowledge, then you have to decide. So, do you, in Periscope land, who's looking at this, either live or it's when it's recorded, and you'll see this, do you want to surrender the right to yourself? Do you want to surrender the right to yourself to the Lord Jesus and His truths and teachings? That's a private thing. There's nobody else involved. Grace, justification, and repentance. Repentance means to turn your life to the truths of Jesus, the apostle and evangelist. Do you surrender your life to do that? If you want to, you can become a Christian. But the decision is yours. I gotta go, folks. My time's up. See you tomorrow on 0900.